custom attributes. So what it's about, let me select that elbow here. And now on the right side in the attribute panel, you see the pipeline number. And below that pipeline number, you see a construction state. And that's now an attribute that does not come from the source system. That's an attribute I created by myself, and I bound it to the pipeline. What does it mean to I bound it to the pipeline? Simply, I told the system that the construction state always belongs to each individual pipeline. So if I'm going to change it, because I have a select list behind it, you see that not only the elbow in red, but also all the other elements of that pipeline in yellow are marked. And if I change the state to prefabrication done, now the elbow has the prefabrication done state, and all the other elements from that pipeline also get the new state. So to make it more visible, we can open up the custom attributes command. And from here, we can change coloring of the model based on custom attributes. So again, let me select construction state. And now directly, you see all those pipelines that own that construction state attribute colored in the state they currently are in. So let's go to this pipeline. This one is ready for installation. So let's assume someone goes out and installs it on site. Then we can change it from ready for installation to installed, and immediately it changes the color in the model. So that's a very powerful way to have attributes or states assigned to any of the hierarchy elements or attributes you already have in your plant. So it does not have to be on a pipeline level. You can do it on an area level. You can even do it on a single element level. So that's up to you. And it's only a simple Excel file for definition. Okay, so hopefully that was not too complicated. I have a second example. So I go out here, and this is a check for leakage. So let's assume during a pressure test, or if you are an owner operator, you should check if the valves have a leakage or not. So also here, I've assigned an attribute now on for all of the valves in my model. And if I click on one valve, now you see it has no leakage. So I already changed the state. And you see now, if I'm going to change this to yes, no other elements are marked in yellow. So that's an individual attribute only for this valve. Still, the valve has a construction state, which is assigned to the whole pipeline. But the leakage here is only assigned to that single valve. And now I can check all the other valves, like this one. Let's say, okay, this one also has a leakage. And this one here I cannot check because now I've inserted also a remark custom attribute. That is not a checkbox. It's just a simple key in field. And here I type in is insulated, and that's the reason why I can't check it. So very powerful system, give it a try. Okay, so let's come to the next feature, which is somehow related. So you see leakage is in red, that means it's currently colored by leakage, and you can use this option to change the color. You can also just double click on the red one to remove the colorization of the model. Okay, the next feature are our custom reports. So you know we had a simple reporting feature in before that just reported on the currently visible objects and wrote the result to an Excel file. Same is available now, so you can just go in and save the construction state, and it opens up in an Excel file, and here you have the result. So we have now inserted the possibility to predefine reports, so you don't have to do the definition by your own. You can just predefine those reports for your end users, and you have the chance to select what scope the report has. So before, in the previous version, only the visible were reported. Now we have the chance to select via the visible, the selected ones, or all objects from your model should appear in the report. Okay, so on top of this, it's now possible to have the report displayed on screen. So here I have my construction state now reported on screen. And here I have all the possibilities that, for example, I set a filter and only let me display those lines that are on hold. Just type in hold in the filter, and now I see three pipelines are on hold. And if I click on any of those pipelines, I have the chance to switch to the 3D model and see where the pipeline is. And if I double click on construction state to colorize my model, now you see, okay, that pipeline is on hold. So maybe now you can go in and change the state to ISO available. And if you go back, you see it has changed here. In order to update the filter, you have just to click return here. Okay, you see it goes in this direction. And also, if I change the attribute here, which is also possible in that on-screen report, to, let's say, prefabrication done, and I switch to the 3D model, you see the pipeline already has changed the color. So that means the custom attribute will be updated immediately in both ways, from the report to the 3D model and vice versa. So that's a very cool feature. And in addition to that, you can also go in and, for example, open my wealth condition report and have two different reports open at the same time and use the same functionality here. So, for example, I want to know what wealths can't be checked. I click on this one, jump to the model, and I colorize by the leakage state. And now I can see what about this one. Or if I send somebody out and tell him, hey, please check all the unknown wealths, just type in unknown here, and then he can just go into the 3D model and see where that wealth is he has to check.